Now, the Wandering Mausoleums were a way within the original base game of Elden Ring to duplicate remembrances, so you can get both rewards from boss remembrances, which no doubt offer the best loot in this game, and rewards to your arsenal. In the Shadow of the Erdtree DLC for Elden Ring, From Software have added in 3 more locations you can go to, where you can select and use those remembrances you have and grab the other item you didn't initially select when using the remembrance within Finger Reader at the round table. In this video guide, I'll show the location to these 3 new spots known as Stone Coffin Altars. How's it going, guys? My name is DPJ, and if you do enjoy the video, leaving a like really helps out. And if you like what you see and want to see more Elden Ring, be sure to subscribe. So the first one we will check out is located within the Finger Ruins of Aria area. So starting from the Cerulean Coast Grace Point, passing by a few graces along the way, we make our way to the first Stone Coffin Altar. Now, well, as I usually do, all timestamps of the graces we do pass by will be timestamped in the video description, just in case players who are watching this may have them unlocked already, saving yourself a little time starting from the start of the route. Okay, so the second one is located right behind the Cathedral of Maenus Mesa, but the entire route to this place starts at the High Road Cross Grace, where we then pass through Moth Ruins, Bonny Village and so forth. Again, it's quite a trek, but we will have timestamps for every grace we unlock along the way. Okay, so the third and final stone coffin altar is located within the hinterland area, which is a hidden area you need to locate a gesture to first unlock. So that's exactly what we will do. So from where we just left off and just went through that second stone coffin altar, if you haven't already, you want to go from here, guys, slightly north and unlock the church district high ground grace, because you want to travel back here from getting that gesture. So once you've unlocked that grace, guys, we now go back to that Bonnie Village grace to get that Old Mother gesture. Now, if you already have this, you can skip this part using the timestamps. So from the Bonnie Village grace, follow this path I take to the statue where this gesture can be found. So once you get here, guys, the gesture should be here waiting for you. Now from here, we want to fast travel back to that Church District Hyrule Grace. And then from here, guys, follow the path I take. Now it's quite a trek. We do scale a lot, but there are many graces along the way, and all will be timestamped down below in case you have some unlocked already. Okay, so once you come here, guys, you need to turn right into this room. Now, when you first get here, there will be a statue here. Using that old mother gesture moves that statue along, allowing you to progress on. So yeah, stand in front of that statue, use that old mother gesture, and that statue will move out of the way. And from this point, guys, just follow the path I take now to the third and final stone coffin altar. And there we have it, guys. If you enjoyed the video, leaving a like really helps out. If you like what you see and want to see more Elden Ring, be sure to subscribe, and hopefully, guys, I will see you on that next one.